The Battle of the Bridges or Kuwaiti Bridges, also known as the Battle of Jal al-Atraf, was a battle that took place on the 2nd of August 1990, in Kuwait following the Iraqi invasion of Kuwait. Chapter 1, Name. The bridges referred to are the two bridges that cross the 6th Ring Road at the junction with Highway 70, west of the Kuwaiti town of Al-Jarrah. Al-Jarrah, a town to the west of Kuwait City, sits astride the roads from the Iraq border to Kuwait City. Jal al-Atraf is a nearby ridge. Chapter 2, Background. On the 2nd of August 1990, shortly after 0 o'clock local time, Iraq invaded Kuwait. The Kuwaitis were caught unprepared. Despite the diplomatic tension and the Iraqi buildup on the border, no central orders were issued to the Kuwaiti armed forces and they were not on alert. Many of the personnel were on leave as the 2nd of August was both the Islamic equivalent of New Year and one of the hottest days of the year. With many on leave, some new crews were assembled from personnel available. In total, the Kuwaiti 35th Brigade managed to field 36 Chieftain tanks, a company of armored personnel carriers, another company of anti-tank vehicles and an artillery battery of 7 self-propelled guns. They faced units from the Iraqi Republican Guard. The 1st Hammurabi Armored Division consisted of 2 mechanized brigades and 1 armored, whereas the Medina Armored Division consisted of 2 armored brigades and 1 mechanized. These were equipped with T-72s, BMP-1s and BMP-2s, as well as having attached artillery. It is important to note that the various engagements were against elements of these rather than against the fully deployed divisions, specifically the 17th Brigade of the Hammurabi, commanded by Brigadier General Rod Hamdani, and the 14th Brigade and 10th Armored Brigade of the Medina. Another challenge resulted from the fact that neither Hamdani nor his troops held any enmity for the Kuwaitis and therefore planned to minimize casualties, military and civilian. According to his plan, there would be no preliminary shelling or protective fire. Hamdani went so far as to require his tanks to fire only high explosive shells, instead of sabot in an attempt to frighten the occupants, but not destroy the vehicle. 2. Chapter 3, Engagement. The Kuwait 35th Armored Brigade of the Kuwaiti Army had been put on alert at 2200 hours on the 1st of August. It took about 8 hours to equip with ammunition and supplies, however, given the limited time and lack of preparedness, the brigade had to deploy before fully supplied and with less than half of its artillery prepared. Colonel Salem departed with the anti-tank company at 4:30, with the rest of units leaving by 6 o'clock. The camp was 25 kilometers west of Al-Jarrah, so they moved east and deployed to the west of the interchange between the Highway 70 and 6th Ring Road. The Hammurabi Mechanized Division of the Iraqi Republican Guard had by this time reached Al-Jarrah. Approaching from the north, its 17th Brigade moved around the west of Al-Jarrah, making use of the 6-lane 6th Ring Road. They were apparently not expecting opposition as they were deployed in road column and were neither reconnoitering nor securing their flanks. This careless behavior and a consistent failure to use communications were to be a defining feature of Iraqi units in the battle. The Kuwaiti 7th Battalion was the first to engage the Iraqis, sometime after 6:45, firing at a short range for the chieftains and halting the column. The Iraqi response was slow and ineffectual. Iraqi units continued to arrive at the scene apparently unaware of the situation, allowing the Kuwaitis to engage infantry still in trucks and even to destroy a SBG that was still on its transport trailer. From Iraqi reports, it appears that much of the 17th Brigade was not significantly delayed and continued advancing on its objective in Kuwait City. At 11 o'clock, elements of the Medina Armored Division of the Iraqi Republican Guard approached along Highway 70 from the west, the direction of the 35th Brigade's camp. Again they were deployed in column and actually drove past the Kuwaiti artillery and between the 7th and 8th battalions, before the Kuwaiti tanks opened fire. Taking heavy casualties, the Iraqis withdrew back to the west. After the Medina regrouped and deployed, they were able to force the Kuwaitis, who were running out of ammunition and in danger of being encircled, to withdraw south. The Kuwaitis reached the Saudi border at 16:30, spending the night on the Kuwaiti side before crossing over the next morning.